You brought up Planned Parenthood. So I said I wasn't going to bring it up, but you brought it up. So,
I did.
So we're going to
Miley Cyrus.
So we're going to go into this really quick. One of the most offensive things that people took was my hat. I was wearing this hat, and that and there's a rifle on my hat, just in case you guys are wondering. And they're like, how dare you talk about pro-life, but yet you're wearing that hat. God. And then some girl wrote a comment. She was like, I've been shot at by one of those.
That's true.
And I do not appreciate. And I almost wrote back, samesies. I almost did that. I opened this up knowing I don't know 100% where you are. Is it anti-abortion completely or not? I said a couple months ago that this is going to become one of the biggest talking points of 2020. When the New York thing happened originally, and then Ralph Northam in Virginia came out, I said, guys, I'm telling you, watch. This is not going anywhere. This is going to become a gigantic thing for 2020. And everybody kind of shrugged it off at first. And now it just seems like every single week it is something else. And it is something going on. What are your thoughts on it?
My thoughts are that murder is not a reproductive right, right? So this murder is not healthcare. And it's scary to think that this mass brainwashing has taken place. By the way, I used to be pro-choice because I went through the public school system. So people are not getting this idea that it's women's rights from, like, they're not plucking it from the sky or researching.
Right.
They're being brainwashed when they're really young and they first learn about sex in health class.
Abby Johnson said the same thing. She was the same way.
I was too. I mean, you can't come out of the public school system and not be pro-choice because they teach it to you like you're deciding whether or not you want to wear black boots or brown boots for the day. Like, kid or no kid. Oh, I'll take no kid. You know, I was irresponsible. And what I hate about the left is that they love to argue with exceptions, right? The exceptional time that a woman gets raped and beyond just getting raped, gets pregnant, right? Mm-hmm. And then now that becomes the whole basis for being able to abort and murder millions and millions of babies.
And that's less than 1.4%, by the way, to be honest. I mean, you know, if we're being honest.
So let's make a whole rule where everyone can now have the option to murder their baby because less than 1.4% of people are dealing with this, something that is actually a tragedy.
Right.
And in those circumstances, you know, that's an entirely different conversation, but they don't want to have the majority conversation because they also say this one, I love this, Planned Parenthood also conducts, what do they say? They also do
mammograms or pap smears and stuff like that.
Which is less than 2% of what Planned Parenthood does.
And they're declining every year in those and going increasing on abortions.
Right.
Because they actually make money on abortions.
Right, that's exactly right. So could you imagine if, like, I don't know, let's talk about the Rwandan genocide. If all their government said is like, oh, we're it's a genocide, but we also do pap smears.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're going to keep murdering
people. Oh, by the way.
But we also do
pap smears. We're over here killing people.
Okay, it's fine. Go ahead, government. Keep killing everybody because the government also in Rwanda was doing pap smears. So it doesn't matter that everybody's dying. But what a bizarre. I mean, I really wonder, like, are they just not, like, thinking when they say these arguments that if you do a pap smear, murder is okay?
Yeah.
Everyone would just be conducting pap smears. Murderers would be conducting
pap smears. Old Jim's a good guy, except he's just murdered a couple people. But other than that, he's a stand-up dude.